I want to actually set the internet free. So it's not that, it's not just about philosophy, it's about action. So that's why I describe myself as a pragmatic revolutionary. Our founder, Matthew Gould, got very focused on this idea of blockchain domains and how they could make cryptocurrency payments better. And that was the initial germ of an idea for the company, and it evolved into eventually what it is today, which is a full blockchain domain registry. We are essentially a registry business similar to VeriSign, which owns .com, except for that we create our domain name systems on blockchains. So what's unique about blockchain domains is they can do two things that a regular domain can't. The first is to be a payment gateway. So you will attach all of your cryptocurrency addresses to this one domain. You can tell it to me, I type it in and pay you. I don't need to know what your crypto addresses are. I don't even need to know which currency you want to receive. So if you've ever made a payment inside of a cryptocurrency wallet, when you go into the send field, you need to remember somebody's 40 character address. Impossible for somebody, for me to just tell it to you. With a blockchain domain, I can just tell you my domain name, you can type it in and you can pay me. And I can use this domain theoretically in any wallet. It's a universal system that can be used by the user and is controlled by the user. That's number one, very unique. Regular domain names don't have this functionality at all. The second is to build uncensorable websites. In the current internet, it's extremely easy to have your domain seized from you, and therefore your website will be taken down. It's also very easy to get your content seized. Like if you store your content on Amazon Web Services or some other service like that around the world, it's very easy to get a takedown. With a blockchain domain, this is impossible. No one can put up the website or take it down other than you. So our goal is to move the entire internet from its current centralized state to a decentralized state. I think that will take 10 years, 15 years, 20 years to do. But that's what we're setting out to do.